Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video I am going to be making some chocolate chip muffins. So basically I've got a recipe which I'll get now. You know me in these videos, I'm so unorganized. So it's from this book, One Mix 50 Muffins. And so basically it's hard to explain. I am going to be using the basic muffin mix, but I'm, because it's just like plain like vanilla I think, but I'm gonna add in some like chocolate chunks, and I want to try and put like a bit across the middle to, I'm gonna do like a little tester for these muffins, these are cookies then, and I want to melt some chocolate, put it halfway in for when I'm putting the mixture into the cake cases and see what it comes out like, because I'm just curious. Like, it probably won't do anything or make any difference, but I thought I'd give it a go. Bit of experimenting, be alright. So, I thought I'd share it with you, and if they are successful, then you could all try them at home. So, and also, you're probably like, whoa, your hair and your jumper is identical to you in your last video. That's because I was did like a little get ready with me this morning, and I was like, I could just use this as a separate footage because it already takes one day, like to upload this video it would have taken like all day, so I was like, and that'll be for like, I don't know, like quarter of an hour tops. So I'm like, if I put in the get ready with me bit, it's gonna be 25-30 minutes, whatever. I was like, do it separate, you can all see what it's like for me getting ready in the mornings. So that's why I'm in the same jumper, same hair, same makeup. So I've just thought you'd all understand. I'm sort of like leaning across this counter because it's quite thin and we don't really have the biggest of kitchens here. So if I'm like this a lot, then you know why. So first off, you need 280 grams of plain flour. So I'm just using Tesco's own because that's what we had in the cupboard. Then you need 1 tablespoon of baking powder. 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 115 grams of caster sugar, then 2 eggs, it says medium, luckily I've got 2 eggs left because I didn't check beforehand, 250 ml of milk, which I've got here, and then 6 tablespoons of sunflower oil, I'm using vegetable because that's all we've got. And then 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, which is there. Okay guys, so I've just seen the recipe and where I said that you need 6 tablespoons of oil, you can actually use 85 grams of butter instead. So I'm gonna do that just because I prefer to use butter in cooking than oil. I think it's better, probably wrong. So I put the oil away. So I'm gonna get the butter out instead. So for this recipe you have to combine all the dry ingredients together and then combine all the wet ingredients together and then mix them together, add in the chocolate, and then hopefully your basic mixture is done. So put the dry ingredients into this bowl. So first off is 280 grams of plain white flour. I always like to put the ingredients away as I go just because then it means I know what ingredients I've left in case I've missed any out, and then if there's none there at the end, you know you've used them all, as long as you've got them all out to begin with. So that's the flour in there, and then next you need the baking powder. So I've got my spoons here. I will sieve this just beforehand because it's a bit, okay, I think you do have to sieve it anyway. Yeah, it says sift together, so that's fine. And then you need, it says 1/8 of a teaspoon of salt. I was putting a pinch of salt because that don't make sense. So that's done. So next is the caster sugar. I'm using granulated. I am aware I don't have any caster sugar in the house. And anyway, these videos, I'm not very prepared. Dry ingredients, and then I will use my KitchenAid here to mix it all together just because it's quicker. So I need to get the whisk. So for the wet ingredients, you need the 2 eggs for here. It. Just push the egg. Is it both bits of egg? Yes, you use both bits of egg. You threw that away then. No shell in there, so I wash my hands. My hands were clean to begin with anyway, so it's fine. I didn't touch those. So then you need the milk, which is 250ml of milk. I just realised the jug has been used and it's not clean. So I'm going to put it into this bowl now we're done, because on our scales we have millilitres as well, so and it does work out the same. So 250ml. Bet you've never poured milk into a bowl like this before. So you also need the butternut. Now it says for the butter to be melted. So I'll have to get the microwave to do that. But melted but cool. So should have done that to begin with. So that's 85 grams of butter. For that will do. So I'm going to put the butter into a cup somehow. So I'm going to melt the butter. Okay, so I have melted the butter. I don't know if you guys can see it. No, it's gonna spill. And there's a few lumps, but it's okay. And it doesn't take long, I think. It did like 18 seconds. I know that sounds precise, but you might need less, you might need more. It depends on your microwave. And I just like put it on for 30 seconds and just pinged it open at any time. So that is gonna go now into the wet ingredients when it's cooled. Because obviously there's eggs, so you don't wanna make scrambled eggs muffins. So the butter is just cooling now because I forgot it needed to. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the vanilla. So I need 1 teaspoon of vanilla. So that's in. What I forgot to show you was the most important bit, the chocolate. So definitely not branded like this video, but it would be nice if it was. So I'm going to go ahead and cut up this chocolate. biggest muffins. You don't want it like the actual size of the chunks, but you don't want it tiny that it's not gonna be noticeable. I'll tell you how much I use because it's not exactly in the recipe. Just judge in how much you think you'll need. So I will measure it for you. So that's 75 grams, which of a mixture of both. So I'm going to chop it up. If I need more, I can add more. If I don't, then that's fine. If I need less, then I can just eat it. You have the spare, so safety first if you are trying to ask your parents for help, because you really don't want to be responsible for you hurting yourself. So the butter is now completely cooled, so I'm going to put that into this with the wet ingredients. So that is now all completely combined. So next I'm going to sift in the dry ingredients. Okay, so you need your trusty old spatula to just wipe around the edge, just so then all the mixture gets evenly incorporated into each other. Okay, so the mixture will look really smooth and silky, which isn't really from this shop, but I can assure you that it is. So the next thing to do is to add in the chocolate that I cut earlier. It looks so good. With the chocolate, you can fold it in by hand, so I can see that it's gonna definitely need more. So I'll do another row of both chocolates. So that will go into here. That I can tell is now evenly incorporated into it. So the next thing is to preheat your oven, which goes on at 200 degrees Celsius if you're using a fan oven, because that's all we've got, so I'm not too sure about what the others would be. So just realize I've only got a muffin thing that's a six like whole one, so I will have to make cupcakes as well. Okay, so I had said about melting chocolate to go in between to mix it with cream. I might not now. I think I'm just going to make a frosting to go on the top using the cream and the chocolate. So hopefully I've got icing sugar. So now you just spoon in the mixture into each of the muffin cases. And so I like to use my ice cream scoop. just because it means that they get sort of equal amounts. Which, if you saw my previous video where I made apple and cinnamon cupcakes, I want to say, I use the ice cream scoop then to make sure that they're all sort of equal. Okay guys, so these muffins go into the oven for about 20 minutes or until golden brown or until you think they look like a muffin. Go with that. So when they're cooked, I shall update you then. Okay guys, so the timer has just gone off, so let's have a look at what they're like. So I will be making a frosting to go on the top. But I'm going to do it on my other channel because, like I've mentioned before, it takes ages for these videos to upload. And if it's too long, then it's just going to be ridiculous time it'll take. So I hope you enjoy like part one of this video, so to speak. But if you did enjoy it, then please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can find out how to make the frosting for them. And also get updates of all the other videos that I'm going to be uploading, as I've got some new ideas, some new content to come soon. So don't forget to hit that notification bell as well, so then you will be notified, because I know some people do have problems sometimes. But I hope you guys have enjoyed this video today, and I'll see you very soon. Bye.